before I forget, what actually caused the hole to rub that hole in the compressor, well, I mean the compressor, the condenser, was behind the grill there is a bug screen. That bug screen wasn't attached properly, so it was vibrating like this going down the highway. And it had to be for a long time, because though that screen is very thin, there wasn't no left to right movement or up and down movement. It was literally, and over time, it kept tapping, flattening out the condenser until a point it wore a hole in the condenser. Crazy, like it was real freakish. So I wanted to add that, but I'm gonna add this to the beginning of the video instead of the end, so you guys know how I got the hole in the condenser, which was wild. But yes, my compressor was bad initially. I showed you guys the first video with that. The compressor went out. I saw it when it happened too, man. I was doing my pre-trip, had the AC running, and then the rubber, there's a rubber bushing in between the clutch on the compressor, and it just spun off and hot, got real hot and melted. And it slung crap all around the belt, and yeah, the compressor took a shot, you know what, out. And then I fixed that, was rolling down the highway, everything was working good, and then the AC got hot on me, and I assumed that it was my seals in the line because I didn't change them, and come to find out, the condenser just rubbed a hole. It was crazy, man. I mean, Murphy and her law. All right, enjoy the video. Peace out. All right, guys, so I ended up going all the way. I didn't put it in the other video. After I checked in and make sure everything was right, running, I didn't change the seals and the lines, which ended up being a problem because my Freon leaked out. Probably about a day or so, day and a half later. So I ended up going back in there and doing the seals on the lines, but where the lines connect to the compressor. Let me see if I can zoom in a little bit. Sorry about that. But as you can see, the lines are there. And there are the seals there. And if you look at the bottom seal, see it's kind of warped. So I bought a new pack right there from Freightliner. Put them on. I got my vacuum gauges on. And we are down to negative 30 below mercury is what we want. Let that stay on for about 15 minutes. And what that'll do is boil down any moisture that was in the lines, which I was talking about before. It's connected to the vacuum pump down here. I'll zoom out. There's the vacuum pump. I'm filming this from inside my bus, so because I don't know if you guys can see, but it's raining. It started raining on me and I didn't want to get wet. But yeah, once we vacuum it down, I'll go ahead and recharge it back up. And then I can see what the pressures are looking like. And then we should be good to go. But otherwise, it performed really good. The AC was working excellent. Like I said, it's just those seals were all screwed up, which that was on me because I should have changed those when I did the compressor. But when I bought the compressor, I wasn't even thinking about it. So I had my buddy pick the compressor up and I wasn't even there. And so it was out of sight, out of mind. I didn't even think about it. And that's one of the things, you definitely should change the seals on the lines where they go into the compressor. So that was all on me. But it was cool because it ended up giving me a chance to get my gauges and find my vacuum pump so I can vacuum it down and do it the right way anyway. So I wanted to share that part two for you guys and get with you later. What it is, as you guys can see, I've changed my clothes or whatnot and was dealing with the truck with the air conditioning. Lo and behold, after vacuuming it down, and like I said, it was supposed to go down to 30 negative mercury on the low side, And it would get down to that 30, but it wouldn't hit that 30 negative, which generally still is a sign of a leak. So I continued to let it vacuum for a little bit longer, and then it wouldn't go down to negative 30. So I was kind of suspecting I had another leak that may have just been random, but you know, I still wasn't sure. So what ended up happening was I went to go to proceed to charge the system up with Freon, and lo and behold, as soon as I started charging, I could see the Freon coming out of the front of the truck, which was a clear sign of condenser. So my condenser is shot. But as you guys can see on those seals, the seals were bad on the AC compressor, but that wasn't the primary issue. I mean, it was probably slowly seeping out from that seal, but there's no doubt in my mind that that may have lasted throughout the season if it would have really leaked at all. But however, I'm glad that I did go in there and change, put new seals on, because you should just do that anyway when you change the compressor. So now I'm in the process of trying to get this condenser changed out. And it's Saturday, the dealer closed already on me at 3. So I got a delivery Monday and a pickup Monday. So I'm hoping that I might be able to squeeze in and swing by the dealer and grab that condenser and get this AC fixed. So I just wanted to give you guys that quick shout out. Other than that, I'm home. I'm going to enjoy the rest of this weekend and, you know, just chill out, man. Got the truck booked up for next week and, you know, looking forward to getting out there, man. Hope you guys are having a excellent weekend, drivers. And I will talk to you. It's your boy QDZ Double Easy coming to you from the crib. Peace out.